Hello, my name is Komi Edovie Gideon. Today we'll be dealing with number base in mathematics. So in our previous video, we did a little work on number base on chalkboard. Like today now, the number base I'm about to give to you, most schools will not be taught. Most of the secondary schools in Nigeria, they won't be taught. So please, I want to pay attention to what I'm going to do now. So let's say example one. Given that 4p4 to the base of 5 is equal to 119 to the base of 10. So let's say solution. So looking at this now, we are looking for p. Let me just say find p. Looking at this, we are looking for p. I'll write 4p4 to the base of 5. Here will be 0, here will be 1, here will be 2, equals to 119 to the base of 10. So we convert from base 5 to base 10. This is already in base 10, so we don't need to touch this part. I'll write 4 times the base, raised to the power 2, plus p times the base, raised to the power of 1, plus 4 times the base raised to the power of 0 is equals to 119. So 4 times 5 raised to the power of 2 give you 25, plus p times 5 raised to the power of 1 give you 5, plus 4 times 5 raised to the power of 0 give you 1 is equals to 119. Then 4 times 25, it will give you 100, plus p times 5 to give you 5p, plus 4 is equal to what? 119. Let's collect like 10. Then 5p is equal to 119 minus 100 minus 4. Since all these numbers, they are crossing to the other part, so automatically 5p is equal to what? 15. Then let's divide both sides by 5. 5 you cancel 5, we have p. Then 5 you cancel 15, we have 3. So automatically this p here now is 3. If you put 3 here, when you solve, your answer will be equal to 119 to the base of 10. So let me give you example number 2. If you are told that what is the value of s in 101 to the base of s is equal to 17. So let's say solution. You might be wondering, is this number base? All these ones, they are there. But most schools, they will just skip them. They will give you the simple, simple ones. So let's go. 101 to the base of s is equal to 17. Remember, this 17 is to the base of 10. So with what is here now, here will be 0, here will be 1, here will be 2. You don't need to convert this. We are converting from base s to base 10. So I'll write 1 times s raised to the power 2, plus 0 times s raised to the power 1, plus 1 times s raised to the power 0 is equal to what? 17. Then with what you say, 1 times s squared, it will give you s squared, plus 0 times s raised to the power 1 to give you 0, plus 1 times s raised to the power 1, it will give you 1, because anything raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. So here will be 17. Then automatically let's collect like terms. S square will be equal to 17 minus 1. Then S square is equal to what? 16. We are not looking for S square, we are looking for S. Then we take square root on both sides. Then the square root, we cancel the square. Then S is equal to what? 4. That is our answer. So let me quickly go to number 3. If you are told to find the value of n in 123 to the base of n is equal to what? 27 to the base of 10. So let's say solution. 123 to the base of n is equal to what? 27 to the base of 10. We are not touching this other part. We only deal with this because we are converting this one to base 10. Then we solve. Here will be 0, here will be 1, here will be 2. I'll have 1 times the base raised to the power 2 plus 2 times the base raised to the power 1 plus 3 times the base raised to the power 0 equals what? 27. Then here will be n squared. Here will be 2n. Then here will be 3. So equals to what? 27. Then automatically n squared plus 2n, let's call it like 10, plus 3 minus 27 is equals to what? 0. Then if we continue, we have n squared plus 2n, we subtract, is going to give you minus 24 is equals to 0. Automatically, if you look at this equation here now, it has changed to quadratic equation. Remember, quadratic equation. Look at the root here, AB here, and this is B. So automatically, we are going to solve this quadratic equation now. Then we are looking for two numbers that we multiply to give you minus 24. Then we add it to give you 2. What are those numbers? Think of it. So I hope that you have gotten it. N squared, the answer is minus 4 plus this n. Then n squared minus 4n plus 6n minus 24 is equal to what? 0. Then let's continue. So what is common here is n brackets n minus 4 close bracket. What is common here is let's say 6. Is it plus 6 or minus 6? That's where your question will come from. Then let's continue to give you n minus 4. So here will be plus 6. Plus 6 to give you plus 6n to give you minus 24. Then equate everything to be 0. So since these two brackets are the same, you take one. So n plus 4, n minus 4 is equal to 0. Then you can now write either n plus 6 equals to 0 or n minus 4 equals to 0. Then n is equals to, if you move plus 6 here to give you minus 6, or if you move minus 4 to this side to give you plus 4. So in number base, we are not looking for a negative answer, we are looking for a positive answer. So our answer will be equals to what? 4. So if you look at this, everything is just somehow strange, but it's very easy. It's very easy to know. Number base is a very simple topic. I believe with what I've given to you, you can do number base on your own. Thanks for watching. God bless you. But please remember to subscribe. Please subscribe so that whenever I drop a new video, you can easily get it. Thanks for watching.